Students, can you see the image displayed on the screen? What is the girl doing? And what is the boy doing? And a man and two women. What are they doing? What do you understand by looking at this image? You can see everyone in this image is commonly using what? Water. See, the girl is drinking water. The boy is watering plant. And a lady is cooking food using water. And a man is bathing. A woman is washing clothes using water. Yes? So here, what is the common thing? Water. So water is important in daily life. See the heading of this image given just below the image. Water is important in daily life. Yes. These regular activities depend upon water. Okay, without water, we cannot survive. So let us go through this concept, go through the text, and let us understand a little more about this water. Water. Now power is gone. I think it's not important to you. The power is not essential for you here. Students, like air, water is also very important for life. Water exists in various forms like solid, liquid, and gas. We get water from different sources such as rivers, ponds, lakes, and wells. But rain is the main source of water. Water from the above said sources is often unfit for consumption. It's due to presence of sand, dirt, mud, and germs. These substances are called impurities. Students, do you have any doubt here? Same like air, water is also very important for life. Water exists in various forms like solid, liquid, and gases. Yes, of course, water is available in solid form and liquid form and gaseous form as well. We get water from different sources such as rivers, ponds, lakes, wells, but rain is the main source of water. Yes, we get water, we get rains in rainy season, right? That's right. So what is the main source of water here? Rain is the main source of water. Water from the above said sources is often unfit for consumption. Consumption means to use. We use water for various purposes, right? You see the people using water in the image, right? The people are using water for various purposes. They are using the consumption of water. This is called consumption of water. The water is unfit for consumption because presence of sand, dirt, mud, and germs. These substances are called what? Impurities. Next, let's move forward. The impurities found in water are two types. Students, the impurities are found in the water are of two types, it seems. You know, impurities found in water are of two types. What are they? Soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. Let us talk about soluble impurities. Students, soluble impurities are the impurities which are already dissolved in water, which can dissolve or already dissolved in water. For example, salt. You know, seawater is salty, right? That may be, it's a part of water in the seas and oceans, but it's not useful for drinking. Okay, so if you want to drink, we treat that dissolved salt as impure, impurity in the water. So we call that water is impure water. So water is impure. Next, insoluble impurities. What are insoluble impurities? Insoluble impurities. What are insoluble impurities? These are the ones that do not dissolve in water, like sand and gems. So these are the impurities that do not dissolve in water. soluble impurities are dissolved in water, but insoluble impurities are not dissolved in water. Okay, like sand. Do you see the sand gets dissolved in water? No. Okay, and even germs also, microorganisms like virus, bacteria, these are all the insoluble impurities present in the water, and even these are living impurities in the water. Okay, so this is about the types of impurities present in the water. What we have been talking in this video, students, we have been talking about water, okay, sources of water and impurities of water and the types of impurities of the water. Remember, students, how many types of impurities we discussed here? Two types of impurities we have discussed: soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. Okay, students, you have to write what are the types of impurities present in drinking water. Yes, students, if you find the impurities in water, what should we do? Should we use same the impurities water like that? No. What should we do then? We should remove impurity from water. So removing impurities from water is the next sub concept. Let us talk about that. You can see that bold letters, removing impurities from water, heading. There are various methods used to remove the insoluble and soluble impurities from water. Let us see what are the methods used to remove these insoluble and soluble impurities from water. Let us see now. First of all, insoluble impurities. Insoluble impurities are separated through the process of filtration and sedimentation. Filtration and sedimentation. Remember, filtration, sedimentation, Asian. If you get such kind of ending to the words like this, that's a process. You just think about that's a process. Filtration is a process of removing impurities, insoluble impurities from water. Filtration, for example, you might have seen your mother making tea or coffee, right? Tea powder is added to milk or water, and after some time it's filtered. The filter is used, no, the process of doing like that is filtration. Same like that, insoluble impurities are filtered using filtration process. Next, sedimentation. Sedimentation is also a process making the heavy insoluble impurities in water make settle down at the bottom of the water. After the impurities, insoluble impurities get settled at the bottom, and then the fresh water remains over this insoluble impurities. Okay, next, let us see what about filtration. Separation of insoluble impurities with the help of a filter paper is called filtration. You know, a filter paper can be used for filtration. Here in the process of filtration, a filter paper can be used. You can see the diagram there. What are the parts present in the diagram? Process of filtration, there is one stand, there is a funnel and filter paper, and water with impurities, insoluble impurities, especially here insoluble impurities, and then clean water there. No, clean water we are getting in the beaker. Where are we getting clean water? In the beaker. See, students, you can understand by looking at the image. I go on reading the text and I will explain. The process of filtration uses a filter paper. A circular piece of filter paper is folded twice to make one cone. This paper cone is kept inside a funnel. You can see in the diagram, students. A beaker is kept below the funnel, and the mixture with insoluble impurities like sand, chalk, etc. is poured into the beaker through the funnel. The impurity is retained in the filter paper and clean water poured in the beaker. Students, I hope you understood this explanation, this text. I don't need to explain further. It's very clearly given there. You can see the diagram here. What's given? One strand is given, foil is fixed to the strand, and a filter paper is folded twice to make a cone and kept in the funnel there. And then, yeah, there is another beaker held by someone. The beaker is with some water with insoluble impurities in that. And then, what are they doing? They are pouring that insoluble impure water in the funnel. And then a beaker is at the downside of that funnel, you can see there, and the filter paper filters the water and gives the clean water in the beaker. And then the insoluble impurities retain in the filter paper there in the funnel. Okay, this is how we can do filtration process to get clean water. Next, what is sedimentation? You know, students, sedimentation can also be used for removing insoluble impurities from water. What is the sedimentation process? Let us understand. Students, sedimentation. You can see there, students, in this process, water is allowed to stand undisturbed in a container. The process is performed in three stages. Students, in this process, what is done? Water is allowed to stand undisturbed in a container for some time. But it's done in three stages, it seems. What are those three stages? Let us see here. First stage, water with insoluble substances is kept in the beaker for some time. Where you can see that water in a beaker, the yellow color water is there in the beaker, you can see in the diagram. That's nothing but impure water. So insoluble impurities are present in the beaker, which is looking yellow in color. Next, second stage, you see the mud settled down at the bottom of the container as sediment. After it is kept aside, you know, after some time, what happens? The mud settled down at the bottom of the container as sediment. Sediment, you know, it's a impure matter present in the water, and that, you know, settles at the bottom. Next, in third stage, you can see the clean water can be poured out into a separate container. Okay, clean water is poured out from where? From the beaker in which the insoluble sediment, insoluble impurities are settled at the bottom. You can see in second beaker, that's only held and separated the water. I have explained earlier, just before, right? Same like that. So this is how sedimentation is done. Okay, and you know, students, separating that after that impurity is settled at the bottom and separating that pure water, that process is called decantation. You can see there, the clean water can be poured out into a separate container. You can see in third diagram there, doing the process is called decantation. Students, remember decantation. Next, let us talk about soluble impurities. So far we have talked about how to remove insoluble impurities from water. Now let us talk about soluble impurities from water. Students, soluble impurities. The impurities are already soluble in water. We cannot see them. Insoluble impurities are seen by our naked eye, but soluble impurities are invisible in water. We cannot see them. So, how to remove them? You can see the images displayed on the screen. Students, so I read and explain. Soluble impurities are more difficult to separate than insoluble impurities. These are separated through evaporation or distillation process. So evaporation is a process and distillation is also a process. Using these two processes, soluble impurities are removed. First, let us follow evaporation process and remove soluble impurities. See, the impure solution with impurities such as salt and sugar is heated till all the water evaporates. The impurity is left behind in the evaporating dish. Students, in this evaporation process, what is done, you know, the water is heated till all the water is evaporated, and then that something remains insoluble, something insoluble thing remains in the dish, you know, that is soluble impurity present in the water. Okay, that evaporated water is pure, that water is pure now. Okay, now let's see what's next. What's next? Distillation process. This process is also used to remove soluble impurities. How can we separate impurities, soluble impurities from this process? Let us understand now. See the diagram first of all. Students, you can see the diagram now. The process of distillation is performed under three steps. What are those three steps? Let us see now. The impure water is taken in a flask and that is heated. First step, what is done? The impure water taken in a flask is heated. Impure water is taken where? Impure water, you can see there, it is written there in the flask. One round bottom flask is fixed to the stand there. You can see towards your left side on the screen. Your left side on the screen. Okay? There is impure water. It's labeled with impure water. It's labeled with impure water. You can see in the round bottom flask. Okay? And it's heated first of all. Then on the second stage, on heating, water is converted into steam. On heating, what happens? The water is converted into steam and the impurities are left behind. Students, the steam is collected and that impurities, soluble impurities, are left behind in the round bottom flask. You can see that. Okay, on heating, water is converted into steam and the impurities are left behind. Okay, next, how can we make that steam into water? When the steam is cooled after passing through the condenser, it turns into what? Liquid water. When it passes through a condenser, when it passes through the condenser, there is a part in the diagram, you can see condenser with the label, you know, with the name condenser. Yeah, the steam passes through it and then there that steam gets converted into water and that water is collected in conical flask. The flat bottom flask there, no, that is called conical flask. Students, the pure water called distillate is collected in a conical flask. Pure water called distillate is collected in a conical flask. You can see there, conical flask. With the name conical flask towards your right side on the screen, you can see the water is collected in the conical flask. That is pure water now. Okay, students, this is how you can remove impurities from water. How many types of impurities present in water? Two types of impurities present in water. What are they? Soluble impurities and insoluble impurities. First, we talked about insoluble impurities. What we have talked just before? We have talked about soluble impurities. How to remove soluble impurities. Okay, students? Students, now let us talk about purification of water. What is purification of water and what we have talked so far before? We have talked about what? Removing the impurities present in the water. That's also the process of purification of water. But here little more matter is given about purification of water. Let us talk about this. I go through the text and explain, students. You please follow me. First, purification of water. Water carries many diseases. Therefore, drinking water needs to be purified before using it. Normally, three methods of purification are in practice. These are boiling, distillation, chlorination. Students, you can see there the matter given. There are three methods of purifications. First one is boiling, next distillation and chlorination.
So it's a process of purification. Purification, it's little different from removing impurities from water. Okay, that's little different from this. Okay, and how can we purify water using these three methods? First method is boiling. Let's talk about that. Boiling is the easiest and the most common method to purify water before drinking. Before drinking, it's very common method and it's very easiest and most common method to purify water before drinking. Usually drink water directly, right? But it's not good to drink directly. But what should we do? We should boil it. Boil it and make it cool and drink. Okay? And after boil it, you just filter and make it cool and drink. That's good. Okay? If you boil it, then if any insoluble impurities are there, they may die, like that's like virus, bacteria, or you know, protozoans, you know, other small small insects, small small germs present in water will die if you boil the water and you filter it and drink. That's good. Okay, that's nice. Next, distillation. Distillation is also purification process. You can see the water stored through the process of distillation is the purest form of water. The water that we get in the process, what? Distillation process is purest water. That's very pure water, it seems. It's free from germs. It's widely used as distilled water in injections, medicines, and car batteries. It's free from germs. It's widely used as distilled water in injections, medicines, and car batteries. Students, distilled water is used for different purposes given here. You can see distilled water is very pure water. It's very purest water, it seems, and it's used in where? Injections, you know. And you might have seen that doctors giving injection, there something used, something liquid is used, that water, that is distilled water. And then medicine also this distilled water is used. And even in car batteries also we use this distilled water, students. Okay, next purification process of water is chlorination. What's chlorination? In this process, the tablet of chlorine is added to the container where the water is to be cleaned. Okay, where the water is to be cleaned, a tablet of chlorine is added to the water and then that water gets purified. You know, chlorine tablet kills germs and make the water pure. Chlorine tablet kills what? Germs and make the water pure. Students, these are the purification processes of water. You know what are the purification processes given here? Remember, students, boiling, distillation, chlorination. With this heading, I want you to write in your notebook, students. Okay, students, almost the lesson is completed. Next, we will see some keywords of the chapter. Okay, students, you just please go through the video for several times and then you will understand what are the points that are present in this lesson, and you please write them in your notebook, students. Here you can see words aid. Atmosphere. What is atmosphere? Thick layer of air that surrounds the earth. Humidity. The amount of water vapor in the air. Air pollution. The contamination of air with undesirable things is air pollution. Next, impurities. Here, unwanted substances like mud, dirt, sand, germs, etc. that make the water unfit for consumption. That's impure water. You know, impurities. These are the impurities. And how to remove those impurities also we have talked about in this video class. Next, what is filtration? Removing impurities by means of a filter. Removing what? Impurities by means of filter. Next, sedimentation. What is sedimentation? Separating insoluble impurities from water by allowing them to settle down. Okay, we have to separate insoluble impurities from water by allowing them what? To settle down. We have to make them settle down and the fresh water remains over that sediment, you know. Sediment is the impure matter present in the water, that insoluble impure present in the water settles at the bottom. No, I have already talked about that.
Yeah.
Students, you just go through the textbook if you have and understand that again. Next, distillation. Distillation is also process. Purification process. Purification of water by evaporating, then condensing it and collecting the resulting liquid. That is distilled water. You know, this process is called distillation. Okay. Next are the points that what we have talked in the chapter so far. And you please go through these points. Next. There is one exercise given. Choose the correct answers. Students, choose the correct answers. These question and answers will be given in the next video, students. I don't want to talk much more about this. Especially, I will make a video about this exercise, you know. Yeah. 10, choose the correct answers, questions are given. And you should give some short answers to these questions. 5 short answer questions are given here. Students, I will make a separate video based on these questions. Students, the questions are displaying on the screen. You can go through them. You pause the video and try to find answers for these questions in your notebook and textbook and write them in your notebook, students. I will discuss separately about all of these questions and answers for these questions in the next video, students. If you want to do them in your notes, you can do. Okay, that's well and good because I have already talked about this lesson now. Most of the answers will be covered in the videos lecture. You please go through them. Okay, students, I will speak about all these exercises and questions. Choose the correct answers, fill in the blanks, matchings, short answers, etc. I will speak in the next video, students. Until then, you please go on watching the videos and you please go through the text and keep watching the videos as many times as you can. And you please give me a comment with your name and class. Then I can understand that you are watching the video, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.